gonna end up with is row U. Now, row U, we said, the U is equal to the Mach number multiplied by the speed of sound. So it's equal to rho AM. Now, if I expand the speed of sound, well, that's equal to rho M gamma RT. Okay, so the flux is equal to rho M, and if I expand T in terms of my stagnation properties, so that's going to equal to gamma R. Where's the equation? Equation right here. So if I expand T in terms of my stagnation properties, and what am I going to get? I'm going to get T stagnation divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 over 2 Mach number squared. Now, if I want to get my density in terms of stagnation property, it's the same principle. We'll get rho density divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 squared m squared. And we have p rho stagnation is equal to p stagnation divided by that's actually one way to also do this if you wanted to. Is just substitute your real gas.
That's
there.
Nice flux.
That's how you could actually determine the equation directly. So from there, the mass flux is equal to p stagnation multiplied by the Mach number, the square root of gamma divided by R T stagnation 1 over 1 plus gamma minus 1 over 2 Mach number squared, the whole thing to the power of gamma plus 1 over 2 gamma minus 1. That becomes our mass flux equation. In industry, actually, we call it the flow number. So, based on this, what I have is m dot, so to drive the choking condition for whatever area that I have to work with, we're going to say m dot is equal to some p stagnation over the square root of R T stagnation multiplied by some function of Mach numbers and gammas. If I lump in this in, I will say, well, it's multiplied by a function of Mach numbers and gammas. Now, if I go and take the derivative of this function relative to Mach number to get my max value at m equals 1 for all gammas, gamma greater than 1. So what I'll get is m dot max based on taking that derivative. So m dot max is at m equals 1, which we already know, the choking condition. That's the maximum mass flow rate that I'm going to get. Obviously, assuming that the stagnation pressure is constant. So, based on this, I'm going to go and divide my choking mass relative to the mass of interest. So, m dot max divided by m dot. And what is that going to give me? It's going to give me m dot divided by a star. In this case will be my choking condition. So this will be my A star plus the area of interest. So divided by M dot over A. So since the mass flow rate is constant, whatever M dot I have here is equal to M dot right here in terms of an absolute kilograms per second. So they cancel out. So what I end up with is area over area star. So, but I already know my max and m dot, so I can say m dot max over m dot is equal to area over area star is equal to the equation that we listed before here. So the p stagnation star multiplied by the Mach number of 1 multiplied by the square root of gamma divided by the square root of r p stagnation star multiplied by 1 over 1 plus gamma minus 1 over 2. The Mach number here is 1, which is the choking condition. Gamma plus 1 over 2, gamma minus 1. Divided by P naught multiplied by M square root of gamma over the square root of R T stagnation multiplied by 1 over A plus gamma minus 1 over 2 multiplied by the Mach number squared, the whole thing to the power of gamma plus 1 over 2 gamma minus 1. So from there, area over area star, the equation that I need to worry about, is 1 over Mach number 2 over gamma plus 1 multiplied by 1 plus gamma minus 1 over 2 m2 to the power of gamma plus 1 over 2 gamma 2 gamma minus 1. And this is the equation that we need to worry about. And we listed one of the other equations. We listed this one. I'll just write them all down here. Integration over t is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 over m squared. And we already know from the relationships p stagnation over p is equal to t stagnation over t gamma over gamma minus 1 and density stagnation over density is equal to stagnation over t 1 over gamma minus 1 and t stagnation over t star is equal to that means it's actually a Mach number 1, so if you substitute in there, what you're going to get is gamma plus 1 over 2 and p stagnation over p star is equal to gamma plus 1 over 2 gamma over gamma minus 1 and density stagnation relative to the choking density is gamma plus 1 over 2 1 over gamma minus 1. And these are all the equations that we need to use in general for compressible flows or primarily assuming compressibility of the engine. One thing to note, obviously the mass flow rate, which we just read in earlier, and Mach number. One thing to note was last year in the final exam, there was something that they had to compute area over area star. And most of your colleagues had this equation in their cheat sheet, but one of your colleagues did not have that equation in there, but he had the m dot equation. And he remembered how to go and get it based on this equation, which is very, very simplistic, but in the exam, can you think of that? So that was pretty impressive, I thought. That he actually backtracked and remembered how to drive area over area star from m dot. He had this equation in his cheat sheet. And he's in a bind and he needs the equation to get this area over area star, so he didn't have this in his cheat sheet and was able to pull this up. So that was pretty good. Now, let's do a quick example to hash this all out. So we're not gonna assume any shocks or so forth or fan of flow or anything right now, but we're just gonna do an example problem on a compressible CD and oscillator. We're not gonna get into the details of underexpanded, overexpanded yet. We can dedicate a full lecture towards that. So we're just gonna look at the compressibility effect of a choking nozzle. So, choked nozzle. So what does that mean about the Mach number of the throat?
One.
One. Very good. And let's assume that it's actually being fed by air. P1 is equal to 0.2 megapascals. T1 is equal to 350 Kelvin. And U1 is equal to 150 meters per second. Find the P at the throat. At the throat and area throat over area inlet. So by define instigation one. P stagnation 1 is equal to P stagnation star is equal to P stagnation. It's an isentropic process, so I'm going to assume it's isentropic. There are no shocks, there are no friction losses, there's no heat addition, it's adiabatic. So, complete isentropic process, stagnation pressures are equal, as well as my stagnation temperatures. T stagnation 1 is equal to T stagnation at star, sorry, and it's equal to T stagnation. So, I have a constant. So, although my pressure and temperature and velocity are going to change in the flow, but what I have is my stagnation property constant all across the nozzle. So, how do I get my stagnation properties? I actually have the equations up there. So, simply, I can say, P stagnation over P star is equal to gamma plus 1, which is the equation that I just listed here, right there, divided by 2, gamma over gamma minus 1. And the same thing with T star. T stagnation over T star is equal to gamma plus 1 over 2. So, if I want to find my throat condition and pressure condition, knowing my stagnation pressure and knowing my stagnation temperature, I can get my throat conditions right there. So how do I go and get my stagnation properties? So, meaning I have my gamma because it's air, gamma of air is equal to 1.4. And what do I know? I'm trying to find this, and I'm trying to find this. Do I have my stagnation properties? How do I get my stagnation properties? So we need
looking at the table.
15 seconds. And that one will be amazing.